Hello, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today we're going to talk all about the most common guitar phrasing devices that make up our playing effects for how our guitar sounds to our listeners. We're going to cover guitar phrasing effects like hammer-ons, pull-offs, ascending and descending fret slides, vibrato, and we'll also look at string bending. I'll show you the basics behind how each one works, and I'll have practice examples for you to try at home. Then, join me on Patreon for the second half of this lesson, and you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to be showing you how these phrasing device effects can be applied in a song or in a solo. I have two melodic examples for you to play through that will get these effects going over both major and minor chords. Those examples will be a lot of fun to play, so make sure you join me next on Patreon for part two. Now, let's begin by playing through our first examples of these guitar phrasing effects. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. Guitar phrasing effects are the effects on notes which are going to add articulation or embellishment upon the way that, you know, a series of notes in a song or a solo are going to really sound to your listener. Now, every instrument has different effects that it can embellish, and the guitar is no different. Two of the main effects that I want to begin with here today are the hammer-on pull-off along with ascending and descending fret slides. So we're going to start with hammer-on pull-off. In fact, we're just going to start here with hammer-ons, and I'm going to be going through an exercise here first with you, and then I'll kind of break it down in detail, but it goes like this. Here it is again. Now, how this works is when you do a hammer-on, the note from behind is played first, and then you hammer on with the tip of the finger very close to the upcoming fret wire to be able to generate a nice clean tone out of that effect. You can even do it without having the note picked in the beginning. You can just slam the finger down. You should be able to get that, you know, somewhat of a tone. It's more pronounced when you pick it first, you know, because you've got some resonance to the string going on and you're, you know, taking advantage of that. But really, that's all there is to it. You want to use the very tip of the finger, you know, the real bony part of the finger slamming down on the guitar string, because that's going to give you that tone, you know. If you use too much of the pad of the finger, you're just not going to get the right tone out of it. All right, so that's how the hammer-on concept works. Just make sure you're doing a really good tip of the finger hammer-on close to the upcoming fret wire, and you'll get that tone real nice. Now, let's check out what's going on with pull-offs. Here's the pull-off exercise. Now, you can tell in these ones, what's happening is we're playing a note above and we're snapping off to the note in behind that we already are pre-fretting there. Now, with the flick of the finger that happens, you want to really move that finger abruptly toward the floor, and that's going to give you that nice tone on the pull-off effect. So the better that you get at flicking that finger directly toward the floor, the better your pull-off effect is going to be going on. So you get a really nice tone out of that, and it's quite easy to do the pull-off. The more difficult one to learn how to do is generally the hammer-on. But practice those, you work through the exercises, you'll have all the tab and music notation for those in your Patreon handout. Let's move over next, though, to what's happening with the fret slide. I have an ascending fret slide idea I want to start with. It goes like this. Okay, a little slower. Now, with the ascending fret slide, we're playing a note and then we're sliding forward into a new note. So we want to make sure that our targeting is really precise. You don't want to go too far or, you know, have the slide be too short, you know, and then miss what the fret is that you want to get to. The fret that you're headed over to, again, when you move into it, you want to be as close to the upcoming fret wire as possible so you get the best tone out of that. And you're just basically learning in the beginning how to do whole step and half step fret slides. So this makes a really nice exercise because it's all comprised of whole steps and half steps. So that's the ascending sound. Let's check out what's going on next here with the descending example. All right, a little slower. So with the descending slides, they're pretty much the same concept that we were dealing with ascending. You just really want to be able to target quite well. So if you're going a half step, make sure your half step movement is really precise. Or if it's a whole step, make sure it's precise. And again, you're trying to move over to the next fret position where you're going to get tone happening very close to that upcoming fret wire, because that's going to give you the nice resonance of the note that you move into. So just making that movement happen precisely into that next fret area is going to be all that you need to practice to have this come together. So, you know, the descending, the ascending fret slides, those are really straightforward ideas. Probably out of all of these, the hammer-on would probably be what I would say is the most challenging for you. All you need to do, though, is just put some good time into this stuff and you'll have some great sounds that'll start happening with these effects. Now, when we take a short break coming up here, I am going to be coming back with some more ideas for you. I got some new concepts with some phrasing effects for you. But when we head over to the Patreon lesson that's coming up after this, I'm going to have some musical examples for you. So we'll have some song clips that we'll move through. They'll have some rhythm guitar backing tracks that you'll get jam tracks for. And we're going to go and put all this stuff into use so that you can really get a lot out of it in more of a musical situation. So we're going to take a short break and then come back with some vibrato concepts as well as some bending ideas. Two other important phrasing devices that guitar players will use as phrasing effects are vibrato and string bending. Now, these ideas are important when it comes to using effects that work to modify the pitch of notes. So, for example, vibrato offers us a great sound effect that helps with a note singing more, and the string bends offer a sound effect where a note will smoothly travel from one tone up through to another. Let's play a few examples of these phrasing effects right now. The first thing we're going to look at is vibrato, and I have some vibrato exercises for you to try. They just sound like this. Again. So to generate a good vibrato, what you need to learn how to do is gently rock the string on its axis. So that's going to be from obviously the nut up to the saddle of the bridge. And you're just basically getting that note to flow. So the note rocks itself. And it sounds balanced. You know, you don't want to go too fast too soon. You want to gauge your vibrato. Sometimes it's nice to have a faster vibrato. You'll notice that Angus Young from AC/DC will often do that. Sometimes it can sound really cool in certain situations. Maybe sometimes not. It just depends on how it's functioning within the song, really. But that's the first thing that you want to do is just rock the note. You can see what I'm doing there is I'm just relaxing and gaining pressure on that finger that's got the note. And you want to learn how to do it on every finger. Have a smooth sound of that vibrato on each finger. So practice an exercise like this where you're generating it with every finger from your fretboard hand. Another thing you want to learn how to do though is use a vibrato within the segment of a line. So I have a statement here, a couple of statements for you to try out. You can try, you know, adjusting speed of the vibrato, doing some of them slow, some of them fast. And just adjust it, you know, practice it, get some different sounds out of it. But as you can tell now with the example of the vibrato, I'm shaking the note kind of in the middle of a phrase. So it's adding it in, and then you're coming out of it to a new note and sort of completing the phrase and the statement. And that's a really great way to be, you know, inventing lines and, you know, inserting these vibrato concepts within the lines that you're playing. So anyway, that's our concept with the vibrato ideas. Let's move on next to our final idea, which is going to be bending. Now, the first thing I want to do with bending is I want to get you to understand that there are four main kinds of bends that you want to learn how to do in the beginning. One's called a quarter step. It's just a tweak. The next one's a half step. It goes up a half step on the guitar. You can hear it. So that's half step. Then full, which is a whole tone. And then the most challenging one is a whole tone plus a half step. So it's really high. It's called a step and a half bend. So you've got quarter, which is like tweaking the note, half step, full, and then step and a half. So, you know, that type of practice is going to be something that you don't want to do a ton of because it can really almost like damage the nail bed underneath your fingernail. So fool around with it a little bit here and there and then move on to something else. And really what the great thing is about bending is you can kind of like insert it within phrases. And I have a phrase here I want to start off with. It goes like this. Again. So I'm getting a bend that happens as a full step on these ideas, and it's starting on the 7th fret 3rd string, moving into a plain old 5th fret E note on 2nd string, and then I've got an 8th fret full step bend, and then I'm going out of that with a faster phrase with 16th notes. Now, in order to test your full step bends, you want to make sure that they do sound like they are up a full step. So make sure that you're going that proper distance with it. It can even be sometimes easier to bend on a thinner string, like a second guitar string. If I have an 8th fret, I can target 10th for a full step bend. You can really tell that, you know, when you're testing it like that, that you're making it to the right place. Now, another thing with making the bend that's really important, I want to mention just before we go on to the final idea, which is kind of a fun one because it's a release bend sound. A really cool sound. Sometimes they call it a crying bend. But before we get into that, I just want to mention something else about the whole bend concept. And that is when you do the bend, it's often more advantageous to hook the thumb over the top of the guitar neck. Gives you a little bit more leverage. And also kind of dig into the bottom of the fingerboard, or the neck, I should say, with this top of your hand here at that first knuckle. So if you do that, it's going to give you a little bit of that, you know, leverage into the bending. So it's going to make it sound a little bit smoother. One last tip I can give you about bending, multiple fingers will give you the smoothest action with the bend and oftentimes give you the most perfect anchor to the next note that you want to move into with that bend. So we're doing a bend right now on 7th fret. I want to make it sound like 9th fret. So I'm on a D. I want to make it sound like E. So I'm using all three fingers, you can tell there, and I'm getting a, you know, nice connection up to that new note that I want. So anyway, in wrapping up, let's get this final segment of the release bend sound down for you. I have an example that goes like this. So what's happening is we're pre-bending the note, so it's already bent up without striking it, and then we're striking it when it's up, and we're just hearing it drop down, and then we're moving to another note or a phrase in there. And then we're going to do it again. So pre-bend, strike, drop the note, and then come into whatever other note that you have. So these ideas of the pre-bend sound, it's a great sound. It's really kind of cool because it does sound like the notes, you know, typically crying or something. Hear it a lot in blues music and everything. So even like classic rock will use these types of bends a lot too. But anyway, guys, that brings us to the end of all this stuff now that we've done for these phrasing effects. They're really important to know how to do. And when you get them down, the opportunity for embellishment and all the different articulation that it really gives you is just fantastic. But we're really not done yet, because if you join me next on Patreon, I've got some really cool stuff that I'm going to be going over with you. It's basically introducing all these ideas into more of a song format. We've done a real exercise format here on the YouTube video, but on Patreon, we're going to get these included more into some phrasing for a musical side of the situation. So I hope to see you next on Patreon. Just go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you're going to get to watch a bonus video where I will be showing you how these phrasing effects can be applied in a song or in a solo. I'll have two melodic examples for you to play through that get these effects going over both major and minor chords. The examples will be a lot of fun to play, so make sure you join me next on Patreon for that second video. And hey, if you're a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you're going to get three jam tracks, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your member's discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.